Hey, X-Fam, I hope you had an amazing Christmas. It's nice to have a break to be with family and friends over the holidays. Perhaps you're watching this on the weekend after Christmas. We didn't have any regular gatherings this weekend because we wanted you to spend some good time with your family. It's been an exciting year in the life of our church. When I think back to how much has changed for the better over this year, it's remarkable. We changed the name of our church this year. We launched a new growth track called X University to help people take their steps in their faith journey. We had 1X this summer where we brought together our two locations for a single outdoor experience at BrewDog. And we saw our new facility in Canal Winchester come up out of the ground. We are excited about moving into it this coming summer. It's been quite a year of new beginnings for our church. New name, new culture, new future. It's been a crazy, exciting year for us. And I just want to say thank you for being on the journey with me. Thank you for staying invested. Thank you to all the servant leaders who have used your gifts and talents to lead others closer to Jesus. And thank you for giving, and even giving above and beyond as we move into 2020 through Exceed. Now I know that many of you give in person, and since we don't have a corporate gathering this weekend, here are a couple ways that you can still give. There's still time if you want to give before we close out 2019. You can give online at www.thex.church/give. It's safe and secure and probably the best way to set up recurring giving. You can also give via text at 614-524-5373. You can also send in a check via mail, but just know it needs to be postmarked by December 31st to count for this year's contributions. And I would encourage you, let's make regular reoccurring giving a part of your life in 2020. As we prepare to flip the calendar to a new year, I wanted to share with you what God has laid on my heart for our church. Can you believe we're actually stepping into the year 2020? And what every new year does is remind us of all the things that we need to change. It's a time when we think about getting our life moving in a certain direction and getting on track. We think about eating better. We think about being better with our money. We think about getting more organized. And we often think it's time to move in a new direction. Many of you may even write down some resolutions or some goals that you want to accomplish this year. I think that's incredible. There's no better time to do that than the beginning of the new year. That's why I'm kicking off this new year with a series of conversations called 2020. Yes, it was so obvious that we're just simply calling it 2020. One of the things I want for every one of you is to have a clear direction or a clear vision for your life. Proverbs 29:18 is kind of an inspiration behind this series. This verse says that where there is no prophetic vision, the people cast off restraint. What that means is that if we don't have clear foresight and vision, we will do just whatever feels good. We won't have restraint in our lives. Think about it in terms of our diet. If we don't have a clear goal or vision for eating better, we won't do it. We might try for a day or even just for a morning until someone comes up to you and says, "You want to get pizza for lunch?" And the answer is always yes, because, well, I'm hungry. And I don't have restraint in the areas of my life, listen, where we don't have a vision. But this isn't just about food. It's true for our relationships, our finances, and even our calling. So I want to prepare you to get the most out of this conversation as we begin the new year. And one of the things that I want to lead our church to do together is a 21-day fast to begin the year. Now, I know that you're tempted to close this video right now. Just hold on. You just wait and hear me out. A fast is not just intended to be some restrictive diet. That's not what this is. And it's not just something we do because we want to lose 20 pounds this year. A fast is where you deny yourself something, maybe a type of food, maybe even coffee, although that might not be good for your coworkers, but so that you can hear something from God. Nothing seems to bring us closer to God when we give up something to connect with Him and to hear His voice. And I want for you to know clearly what God wants to do in and through your life. And I believe that most of us desperately want that. The times in my life when I have felt restless or uncertain have been when I wasn't sure what I was doing was what God wanted me to do. And in those moments, can I just tell you, I didn't have peace. And I believe that one of the ways that we can get clarity is to start the year off with a fast. I've actually been doing this for many years personally, but I wanted to invite you to do it with me. So what I wanted to share this video for was so that you could get mentally, emotionally prepared to go on this journey with me as we start 2020. So starting this weekend, both Thursday and Sunday, I'm gonna talk about how we are going to find clear vision for our lives, and how we can do this together. We'll begin our fasting starting on Monday, January 6th, and we'll end our fast at the end of the day on Sunday, January 26th. We will give you some resources on the weekend that will help you in choosing a fast. I tried a few of them. There's a popular one called the Daniel Fast. There's a lot of resources out there for that. Maybe that's one you'd like to do. I've often done one where I give up meat or sweets and social media. I particularly think fasting social media has been so helpful for me at times. It helps me get into the right state of mind. So I want to give you, here are a few things that you could consider to prepare. Maybe consider journaling. In fact, I've got my journal with me. If you don't already journal, can I tell you, this is a great time to write your prayers down each day of the fast. This is my journal, and I regularly write down things that I'm seeking God about. It's a great way to connect with God. There's also a lot of different resources out there that can make this fast more meaningful. Here's another one that many of our staff are actually going to be using during this fast. It's a small devotional book called Pursuit by Dave Patterson. And it's a full journal that you can go through that will really help you grow during the season. So I wanted to let you know about this because maybe you want to order something like this off Amazon, have it in time as we begin our fast. And so listen, if you're in a place where you need God to do something in your life, or maybe you want more clarity about the direction of your life, can I just encourage you, jump in with both feet and let's do it together. I believe that this year can be one where God moves so powerfully in our lives and in the life of our church. Imagine what God will do if an entire church would be so dedicated to Him that they would fast and seek Him for direction. And so I want to encourage you, prepare your heart and your mind, and let's get on this journey together. Hey, I love you, church, and I hope you have a wonderful and safe new year, and I'll see you this weekend.